Hello friends, today we are going to discuss about Organ Donation Day. I'm Dr. Suresh Badadmat, Professor of Psychiatry, working at NIMHANS, Bangalore. In this video, I'm going to discuss about Organ Donation Day. Why we should have a designated day for organ donation? What is the importance of this day? And what is our role? Actually, role of every citizen. Organ donation is a way to continue to live forever. Organ Donation Day is observed on every year 13th of August. The reason for having 13th of August as an Organ Donation Day comes with two important aims. To motivate every citizen to pledge to donate their organs after death. To spread awareness about the importance of organ donation. There are various challenges with regard to organ donation. This is because of due to lack of awareness. There are various myths circulating in the society. Religion, rituals, and culture also play a crucial role in coming in the way of organ donation. There are various myths. Some of them are brain death versus coma. People equate coma means brain death. Unfortunately, there is a lack of awareness. In coma, there is electrophysiological activities continue to exist. Whereas in brain death, there will be complete absence of EEG or else electrophysiological activities. Once the brain death is declared, then only the person is declared as dead and then the organ donation is done. Many people do not understand brain death and coma, including medical professionals. This is unfortunate. And another important thing everyone should know is the transplantation team is different from the team which declares brain death. They are two different teams which are unrelated. Invariably, the organ donation occurs in a different hospital and the procurement of the organ occurs in another hospital, maybe in another city. This needs to be driven into the hearts of every citizen. Further, because of organ donation, the mutilation of the body occurs. That is one of the biggest myths. Invariably, the organs are taken without causing much mutilation of the body. The another important myth is soul will not be complete. If the body's organs are taken, the soul will not reach to the heaven. We forget this body is perishable. The organs can be harvested. Nobody takes organs to the heaven. That needs to be remembered. Many people also think that if the organs are donated in the next life, they may not have that organ at all. These myths need to be busted and facts need to be provided to the population. Organ donation is defined as a gift of an organ to a person with end-stage disease and who needs a transplant. Please remember, it's a gift of an organ. That means it cannot be commercial commodity. That's how our law has clearly defined organ donation. Hence, please remember, organ donation means a gift of life. It is not a commercial or a trade entity for a life. Why we need to be aware of this organ donation? In India, approximately 5 lakh people die each year waiting for organs. This is the saddest part of our country. They wait, but they do not get the organs. There is no exact data, but the available data clearly says that every year, 1,75,000 people require kidney transplants and they do not get. Hardly we are able to meet 5,000 per year. Similarly, 1 lakh people are waiting for cornea transplants every year. 1 lakh liver transplants. 50,000 heart transplants. 20,000 lung transplants. Unfortunately, there is a huge demand, but supply is very small. There are more number of patients adding every year for the need of organ donation, but donors are very less. If you look at the demand and supply, India has among the lowest rates of organ donation in the world. It is 0.5 donor per million population. If you look at the various Western countries, they are around 30 to 40 donor per million population. This needs to change. There is a need for paradigm shift. We bury the dead bodies, or we burn the dead bodies, but we do not think of donating them. This needs to change. I'm talking about cadaver organ transplantation. This can be done easily in our country. The technology has made leaps and bounds, but unfortunately, our thinking process has not changed. Look at the numbers. One donor can save 8 lives and heal 75 lives by tissue donation. This is an amazing number. Every person can live even after death. Every person can be a hero in death. That means, again I am emphasizing, one organ donor can save 8 lives. Live beyond your life. What can be donated? Organs and tissues can be donated. Organs such as heart, liver, lungs, pancreas, kidneys, and intestines can be donated. Tissues such as cornea, heart valves, skin, bone, ligaments, and veins can be donated. Let's understand the legal perspective of organ donation. There are two important legislation, but the principal legislation which deals with organ donation is Transplantation of Human Organ Act, passed in 1994, which was amended again in 2011. This deals with organ donation. With regard to dead body donation, is covered under Anatomy Act. This Anatomy Act varies from state to state because it is a state legislation. Coming to the principal legislation, that is Transplantation of Human Organ Act 2011. This legislation was passed with an intent of regulating the removal, storage, that is harvesting, and transplantation of human organ and tissues for therapeutic purposes. That is the first aim. The second aim is prevention of commercial dealing of human organs and tissues. That means human organs are not a commercial commodity. That needs to be understood very clearly, my dear friends. If anybody is involved in commercial dealing of human organ, they will be penalized. They will be jailed. They will be imprisoned. Let's understand there are two important types of donation under this legislation. One is living donor. Another one is deceased donor. Living donor can give kidney, pancreas, liver, and tissues. With regard to deceased donors, any organ and any tissues can be given. As I mentioned earlier, deceased donor can save 8 lives and also 75 lives healing can occur by their deceased donor. Who can donate? Anybody can be an organ donor, irrespective of the age, caste, religion, community, and region. Even children can donate, but the family members or the parents need to consent. Donation of organ is based on a strict medical criteria, not based on age or any other criteria. Commercialization of organ is banned in India. Who can be the recipient? Even the recipient who is going to receive this organ is also based on various medical criteria, such as blood type, tissue and genetic matching, time since waiting period, severity, urgency, the body size. So various criteria are placed. And also there are two important waiting lists. One is urgent waiting list, another one is general waiting list. Depending upon the availability of the organ, depending upon the recipient's urgency or the waiting list, and also various matching, on that basis the organ is given or distributed across the country. The central government maintains the national registry of recipients and also the donors. So, what is the organ distribution protocol? If there is an organ available, that will be initially distributed locally. If it is not available, the matched recipient, it will be transferred to the regionally, and if not, nationally. That means there is a strict criteria followed and it is highly transparent at this point of time. This technology has played a very crucial role. Transparency is maintained at every step. Organization of Monitoring, DOA Act, comes under three important statutory bodies. They are National Organ Tissue Transplant Organization, which is called as NOTO. At the same time, there are 5 Regional Organ Tissue Transplant Organization and State Organ Tissue Transplant Organization, also called as Nodal Agency. So these are the important organizations which play a crucial role in organ harvesting and also distribution. Now, let's understand what is your role, what is my role, and every citizen's role with regard to organ donation. We need to pledge, because we die, our body perishes. If we donate our organs, we can still will be alive in somebody else's body, and we will be fresh in their memories. We can change their lives. We can change their families. These are the various internet sites where you can go and pledge your body and also organs for the purpose of helping others. So this is the central government organization, noto.gov.in. If you go there, you can pledge your organs. Please log in or else register yourself for donation. This is how the donor card looks like. Please pledge your body and also organs for the purpose of donation. Please procure this donor card. Discuss with your family members. That is very essential. And then enroll for donation. But remember, this is not a one-time affair. You can withdraw anytime. Not only that, once by chance, if there is a brain death, now the family member also should consent to give your organs. If they refuse, that means it becomes invalid. Hence, it is essential to discuss with your family members before you pledge your organs. To conclude, my dear friends, there is a need for massive awareness campaign with regard to organ donation. Organ donation is very simple. Cadaver transplantation can be done easily across the country. Registry of donor and recipients is very essential. Transparency is the key. Because of digital world, now the transparency is available. Organ retrieval to be facilitated at all government and private hospitals, because harvesting is very easy. That means a little effort, that means every hospitals can start retrieving the organs for the purpose of transplantation with adequate checks and balances. Cost of transplantation need to be borne by either the government, NGOs, or else someone else, because many poor people may not be able to offer this organ transplantation. Sensitization of police, forensic medicine, CMO, and public at large is very essential. Please remember, commercialization of these organs is completely prohibited. All state governments need to invest in public health so that organ can be easily harvested and donated to the required recipients. This year, on 13th August, don't forget to pledge your organs. Become an organ donor. Give the gift of life. Do not forget this organization and also the website, noto.gov.in. Please pledge your organs, save somebody's life. Thank you very much for giving your valuable time. Stay safe.